Hare Krishna. Don't be annoyed that people are so bad. Be amazed that they aren't worse. Often, people annoy us, they upset us, they let us down. And at such times, we may start complaining. This person is so bad, that person is so bad, that person is so bad. So now, at one level, our emotion and our reaction are understandable. But at the same time, we can recognize that such complaining, moaning is not particularly helpful. And actually, if we broaden our perspective, we will understand that everyone is struggling, that everyone has issues, that everyone has their own weaknesses, their own worries, and everybody is carrying an invisible burden which we may not even be aware of. Just as if we look at people around us, we feel that people don't understand what all we are going through, how many challenges we are facing and still moving on. That's true, and it's also true that we don't know what people are going through. So if you could have the time or the receptivity, and people would have the openness to share their hearts, we would realize that everybody is carrying an huge burden on them. And the misery that life sends to everyone, this is just, it's just the nature of this world. Krishna says in the Bhagavad-Gītā that this world is dukkhalaya. In 8.15, he said that this world is a place of misery. And a common response to misery is malevolence. When faced with distress, many people become outright evil. They start getting towards violence, mindless violence, towards destruction. And this is something which can happen to anyone. We may think that somebody is a good person, but when many, many bad things happen to good people also, they might also snap and do something terrible. So, and everybody has had bad things happening to them. So the fact that people around us are not terrible, that that we are not at each other's throats, just as we could say people in the more people, wild, mad people, say criminals, gangsters, ruffians are sometimes, the way that the most of human society is not like that, that is surprising. And if we have this attitude that with that actually everyone is having a huge burden and everyone could react to that by breaking down, by becoming destructive. And there is that tendency to destroy which is there within everyone. There are three modes of material nature, and the three modes, everybody is bound by these modes. Everybody is being pulled here and there by the modes. Say, actually the Bhagavad-Gita says that sattvam rajastamaiti guna prakriti sambhava nibadnanti mahabaho dehe dehinam avyayam. That we are all bound by the modes and we are all being pulled here and there. So given that, especially in the mode of passion and ignorance, one can become destructive when one's desires are thwarted and one's distresses seem to become unbearable. So when we see that everybody is struggling and everybody has that potential for destructiveness, then we can become empathic, understanding that people, when people don't seem to be understanding, that by seeing what burdens they are carrying, by seeing how they are also conditioned, you know, we can stop blaming them. Even if we can't help them practically, imagine if somebody were walking twisted and we may complain, why is this person walking twisted? But if we saw that they were carrying a huge burden, and then rather than blaming them for carrying, for being walking twisted, we could either help them to carry the burden or at least empathize with them, understand what they are going through. So we are all struggling. We all have challenges. And in one sense, we are not fighting against each other. We are all battling against the nature, against this world, where distresses come upon us and distresses can bring out the darkness within us. So by being grateful, when we turn towards, when we understand that everybody is struggling, we can become more understanding towards them. And by that, we will find that as we try to empathize with others, others will empathize with us. And this difficult journey through this difficult world, we won't make it more difficult, but we will ease it for ourselves and for others. Thank you. Hare Krishna.